Before we start this evening, I'd like for us all to just take a moment to remember Senator Kirk, who had a stroke and is recovering, and just to do all, keep him in our thoughts and prayers. Thank you. Now, I'd like to say that we want to thank everybody for showing up. Because that's half of us just showing up. And we are very, very pleased and proud that we have an opportunity to acknowledge the contributions and to show our deep respect for someone who has always done more than just show up. Especially on behalf of children and families for Illinois and for the country, and especially for those children who are at the greatest risk. So, I'd like to introduce our Head Start parent, Ms. Tanisha Scott Johnson.
Programs, especially the Head Start project for preschool children, now called Head Start. She served as the honorary chairman of the National Head Start project. So she was the inception and there in the beginning. So Head Start was given enormous visibility when it was supported by the First Lady, Betty Bird Johnson. She was a strong advocate for Head Start, a true champion for Head Start. And this award was first created in her name by the Massachusetts Head Start Association, who named it after Claudia Betty Bird Johnson. Back in the year 2007, Senator Edward Kennedy received the award. So you can see the words that I used to describe, and you'll hear them in the remarks tonight. So I'm going to turn it over to my colleague and another special lady, Mary Burns, who is the Region 5 Head Start Association.
Welcome, everybody. I hope there are some Region 5 people here with us. I'm delighted to be here. I don't really know Senator Durbin. Marvelous things about you. And I do know this much. I know that you really, really care about children and families. And for us, that's the most important part. And it's especially great to have somebody like Vanessa Smith, who cares about the neediest children in this nation, who are our future. So thank you so much for being here. Now I'm happy to introduce Chuck Parr, who is the president of the Illinois Head Start Association.
Well, I do know Senator Durbin. In fact, I've known Senator Durbin since he was Representative Durbin. Back in the 80s, Senator Durbin has visited my agency in Alton, Illinois, Madison County, Illinois, as a representative and as a senator. He was first elected to the House of Representatives in the mid-80s, 85 or 6, I believe it was. He's been in the Senate since 1996, and he is now the Assistant Majority Leader, Majority Whip. Time's limited, so we can't talk about all the committee work that he has done over the years and all of his accomplishments, but I did want to pull out just a couple of headlines that really tell us best what the senator has done for Head Start. This is the headline: Durbin calls on Bush to support Head Start expansion. Durbin says cuts to Head Start will devastate low-income families. Your speeches and your articles have really been invaluable to us in Head Start, have given us inspiration. He once said, investing in education programs like Head Start produces the world-class workers that are key to our nation's future. He's been an ardent supporter of Head Start since day one and really has helped us strengthen Head Start in the best of times and in the worst of times. He stood by us irregardless of the situation. So on behalf of the nationwide Head Start community, Senator, it's my honor to present you to Lady Bird Johnson, Head Start hero.
I want to thank you for the kind words. I want to acknowledge Desmond Vinci, who said hello when he came in, as well as Ron Hearn. Not here, but as chairman of your National Historic Association. This is a big night, as you probably know, State of the Union Address. It's interesting that you would pick this day to be here, because there's a connection. Some of you know that connection. And the connection relates to a State of the Union address many, many years ago, 1965. And sitting up in the gallery, as Michelle Obama will be sitting this evening, was Lady Bird Johnson, First Lady of the United States, as President Lyndon Baines Johnson gave his State of the Union address. She listened to the State of the Union address from her husband, and said, you know, her husband said, I'm going to use the power of my office to make America a better place and to end poverty, his war in poverty. And before she returned to the White House that night, Lady Bird Johnson said, I want to be part of this. So she called up a man named Sergeant Schreiber, who was an extraordinary man, who passed away just very recently. I knew him a little. I know his kids much better, children much better. And he was an extraordinary leader under Lyndon Baines Johnson. He was the man who set up the Peace Corps. He was the man in charge of the War on Poverty. And he was the leader that they went to when they wanted to put together a program to address a major issue. So Lady Bird Johnson called Sergeant Schreiber, and she said, what can I do? And he said, well, there's a little project we have here. It's new. It's an 8-week summer program. That's all it is. But it might turn into something big. We work with 3 and 4-year-olds from poor families to try to get the kids ready for school. And we call it Project Head Start. So the secretary is as smart as people should find. She said, do you think this would work? And they should get behind this. And he said, yes. And as they filed in the room, Sergeant Schreiber went over and said, you know, it would be great if you would assume the role of Head Start's first honorary national chairman. Lady Bird wrote in her diary that night when she got back to the White House, I'm inclined to say yes, although I don't like being just honorary anything. If I take it on, I want to work on it. And boy, did she more than any single person, launched Head Start in that administration when so many things were happening. That was her passion. That was what she was there to work for. And her legacy is obvious. In our state of Illinois, more than 51,000 kids and families, and across the nation, hundreds of thousands that are helped every single day by the Head Start program. Sometimes this great, wonderful, honorable job I have is a pain in the neck. And sometimes you think, why do I come here, hit my head against the wall, and go back home and wonder why I'm getting on another airplane to come back and do it all over again? And what I found is that when I really get so low, I go to the Head Start program. See if I can still fit one of those little chairs. I get down there with those kids, either splashing in water or playing with sand and doing all this stuff, and read a book to them and all that, and all of a sudden it all comes back to me. What this is all about. It may be frustrating out here, but when you fight a fight to keep a program like Head Start alive, it's a meaningful part of the lives, not only of the kids, you know this part, but the parents too.
Yeah.
That's been his own. Talking about America's role in the 21st century and creating jobs, my advice, stick with Head Start. You get these kids started in the right direction. Get their parents reading to them and talking to them and understanding what will be expected of them, and good things happen. No, great things happen.
Great things.
So I thank you, because now I'm looking at this from a new perspective. On November the 15th, our daughter had twins. So go ahead. We're rusty with twins, with my daughter who lives up in Brooklyn, New York, and her husband. And I'm rediscovering things which I was way too young when this, I went through the first round of our kids, you know, and my wife was even younger. And some of the stuff just flashed right by us. And now, as grandparents, he smiled back at me. So, we're going through this with a clear understanding that every minute of every day we have an opportunity when we're with those kids to make a difference in their life for years to come. And little things and time spent reading the book, showing them things, taking them out, talking to them, is going to mean that they're going to have a better chance in life. Head Start does that on a national basis. Thank God you do. Thanks for the award.
Chicago and Illinois, thank you too.
Yeah.